Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I thank God for this fine and wonderful day. I feel the presence of God. God and His presence is in the midst of us. How many of you believe that? Before we go into the message, let us close our eyes. Heavenly Father, I thank you, Father, for giving this fine, wonderful day. The message which I am going to preach is not from coming from my mind or brain, but it is from totally from the Holy Spirit. Let the Holy Spirit touch each and everybody. Let their hearts be turned and turned in order so as to repent. Lord, my Father, I pray in Jesus' name that the message turn their leaves, turn everything there from their sadness, from their poverty into God's blessing. Hallelujah. I pray in Jesus' name that the anointing come upon each of the Lord who are listening this message. Let the name of Jesus be exalted. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. Today God has given a fine, wonderful day. I told you that His presence is in the midst of us. Jesus has said one promise to us in the New Testament as whenever we two or three people gather together, wherever two or three people gather together, Jesus has promised that He will definitely come. That is sure, 100% sure that if two or three people gather together, Jesus will come in the midst of us. How many of you believe that? Jesus is standing between me and you. How many of you believe that? Maybe you are watching this message through any TV or in the YouTube or in through Facebook or some other media. But one thing you have to understand is Jesus is standing in between me and you. Hallelujah. The word which I am going to give you is from John 14:16. The word says that Jesus says to His disciples that another helper who is called the Comforter will come when Jesus goes back to heaven. You know that Jesus lived in this world 2000 years back, and while He was with His disciples, He had said so many promises, and one of the promises, the main promises then, was the promise of the Holy Spirit to come. Hallelujah. And actually, when Jesus was alive and He was doing His ministry in Bethlehem, in Jerusalem, and all around Israel, you know that after when Jesus left the disciples, after His resurrection, after His death, after 3 days after His death, on the third day He resurrected, and the disciples, almost 120 disciples, among them was with their Jesus' mother. They all gathered together and waited for the Holy Spirit on the upper room. And on the 50th day, that was on the day of the Pentecost, the Holy Spirit came upon them and they spoke in different languages. They spoke in languages of different nations. They spoke in languages of heaven. Hallelujah. So our God is a God who fulfills all the promises. But one thing you have to understand is that in order to fulfill a promise of the God, you must be obedient to God. If you are not obedient, if you are not going under the law, or if you are away from the law of God, if you are not obeying what it is written in the Bible, you cannot achieve any promise, because our God will fulfill all the promises if He is pleased with you. You know that Abraham was given all the blessings. Wherever you go, you will be blessed. Wherever you enter, you will be blessed. So many promises are upon Abraham, and all these promises was fulfilled in him, in his life. He lacked a child. He lacked so many things, but God gave everything to him. He left out of his home at his young age. At his young age, he used to pray in the wilderness. He used to pray in the desert at night, day. So one day God told Abraham, you leave your family, everything. He was a rich man. He had cattle. He had much money. He had parents, relatives, everything. But when God told him to leave out of that place where he lived, he left his father, his mother, relatives, cattle, all his riches, everything. He left and he went to the place. But he doesn't know where to proceed, where to go. But God told him, Lord told him, Abraham, you go. And he went out of his house without knowing where to go. That God was pleased with Abraham. After so many tests, you know that Abraham was tested by giving his one and only son to Lord. And Lord told not to kill his son Isaac, because God only wants to test him. So after that test, when Abraham succeeded in that test, he got all the blessings. One of the blessings was that whoever curses you will be cursed, whoever blesses you will be blessed. I tell you that today, if you have heard any promises from any prophets or from any other God servants, or if anybody has laid their hands upon you, and till this time, no prophecies are not seen in your life, understand one thing, that the problem is not with God, but it is with you, because you are now not yet pleasing God. You are living in a life which is away from Bible. Understand one thing, because our God is a God who fulfills all the promises. One verse I am going to say is that in Philippians 4:19, he says that our God supplies all needs, all our needs God supplies. Who thinks that God is not providing anything? God provides everything. Even Abraham went up to the mountain to sacrifice his son, but God already provided a lamb for Isaac. Instead of Isaac to get sacrificed, Lord provided a lamb there on the top of the mountain. How can a lamb come on the top of the mountain? How? It is a desert. How a lamb will come on the top of the mountain? Who brought that? Is there anybody there? Only Abraham and his servants. While climbing up the top of the mountain, Abraham told his servants, let me and my son go and worship the Lord. And he woke up early morning. You know that in order to give his one and only son, which he doesn't like to give, the word which Abraham used was to worship Lord. You know, the word which Abraham used was to worship the Lord. Now understand one thing. God was pleased with Abraham. And after that, he was given all the blessings. Amen. Hallelujah. How many of you are happy? Jesus is now touching each one of you. You are going to get all these promises. Those who are hearing these messages, understand one thing. God is going to touch each one of you. And those promises which are not yet fulfilled, in these coming days, God is going to fulfill these promises. You know, I was a man who doesn't even know to speak English. I studied in an English medium school, but I never used to speak English. But when I came to know Jesus, and when I was doing the Lord's work, one day God anointed me with this English. God invented, God created the English language, and he filled me with the English. So I am preaching the gospel to you in English. It is all by God's grace. Again, I am going to the verse. How many of you believe that God's promises will be fulfilled? Hallelujah. In Zechariah, the book of Zechariah 9:12, it says that God says, whatever has lost, I will repay the double of it. Whatever you have lost in the past, I will repay double. Hallelujah. One thing you have to understand, that if you have lost financially, or if you have lost peace, or in your family, happiness you have lost, if you come to Jesus, you will get back what you have lost. That God will give is not God is saying, but God will give the double of what you have lost. Hallelujah. God will give you the double of lost, what you have lost. But you know, in the book of Mark, we can see that in Mark 10:28, Peter is asking Jesus, Jesus, we have left everything for your sake. We have left our house, wives, children for your sake, and we are following you day and night. We are with you. So what will we get? Peter was asking. And you know what Jesus said in the verse 29 of Mark 10. Jesus said, whoever forsakes his wife, children, family, house, cattle, lands, everything for my sake or for the gospel's sake will be given to you in hundredfolds. Surely, he's saying, assuredly, he says, there are only a few instances in the Bible said assuredly, because he's guaranteeing. Whatever he has promised, he is able to fulfill it. We can see that so many people in the world say so many promises. Even parents, they promise their children, when you grow up, I will give you this and that. I will give my property, everything. But we can see in the newspaper, we can see in the news, we can see from wherever we are staying, from the surroundings, that their parents have later changed their plan because they dislike the children's behavior. Understand one thing, that. But our God doesn't change our plan. If only we change, we depart from God. We only if we depart from Bible, only if we stay away from the word of God, then only God will change his promises. Our God is a God who fulfills his promises. And God has told that whatever, and Jesus has told that whatever you have forsaken in my sake and for the gospel's sake, you will get that in hundredfold. Surely I say, those who are doing the Lord's work without having any calculation in your mind, without having any thinking about any future, if I do for the Lord, if I work for the Lord, if I get any benefit, then I will do in happiness for the work. Those, I am not saying about such persons, but those who without any calculation, without any thinking about future, those who do the Lord's work without getting any, without thinking about any gain to be, that I am telling about such persons, that you will get all the promises fulfilled. Because in the Bible it is written so many promises in the book of Deuteronomy from verse 1 to 14, all it is written, all the blessings of God. And from 14 to the rest, to the end of that chapter, it says all the curses of God. But I say you that each and everybody should read the book of Deuteronomy, and you must achieve all the blessings what God has said in that. And if there is any curse in you or any curse in your family, you must kneel down, you must fast, you must repent, change your heart and come close to God and cry to God, Lord, restore me in my old position and give me all the blessings. That you must do. Let us come into the verse again. Because in Joel, in the book of Joel, in Old Testament, chapter 2, 28th verse says, I pour my spirit on everybody. Because God has promised that in the end time, all my children, all grandchildren, all your children, all your grandchildren will be filled with the God's Spirit, and everybody will prophesy, everybody will speak in tongues, everybody will interpret. God has promised that. And in the end time, we are in the end time, we see that so many God's servants are moving and going around the nations in North India and in all over the country, all the nations, we can see that. Everywhere the gospel is preached, everywhere the posters, notices are seen. Because why? So many notices, so many fasting prayers, so many seminars, conferences are being held in these days. Why? Because it is the end time and Jesus' second coming is nearing. How many of you are eagerness are in waiting for the second coming of Jesus? Because Jesus is coming very soon. So we are in the end time, and God, before that end time occurs, before the second coming of Jesus occurs, God has to fulfill his promise. His promise was that to fill each and everybody with his Spirit. And you know that in the early days, Holy Spirit was filled with only few people. But now in these days, so many people are being filled with the Holy Spirit. How many of you understand that? Hallelujah. In the book of Genesis 12:12, in the book of Genesis 12:12, God told Abraham that I will give you a nation, I will bless you, I will multiply you, I will give you children that you cannot count. What Abraham lacked was he didn't have any children. He had much wealth. When he left out of that place where he was born, he came only with Sarah. He never thought that they were old at that time, but Abraham never thought where Sarah will get buried if she dies. But you know, God took care of Abraham. And when Sarah died on the way, Abraham got a place. He purchased a place on the desert, nearby desert, and buried Sarah there. Our God takes care of our every needs. Because now in these days, many people keep a distance to come too near to Jesus, because they are afraid of their church. They are afraid of their priest. What they say is that if we come too close to Jesus, if we do God's work, if we do gospel work, our names will be cut from the church. We can see in the book of John chapter 9, a blind man was healed, and his parents were afraid of the scribes and Pharisees, and his parents were afraid of the Jewish priests and leaders, and they told him, we don't know whether he was born in blind. You ask that person, you ask my son, he knows whether he was blind. That means his parents doesn't know whether his child was blind or not, because they know that he was blind, but they were afraid. I'm telling you that. Don't be afraid of anything. If you are afraid or if you feel shy before God, before people, one day when God comes, he will also reject you. He will also put you out of the kingdom, and he will place other people instead of you. But understand one thing. What I am telling about you is the promise of God. How many of you have heard the promises of God? If you have heard the promises of God, what you have to do is I am telling you how to achieve the promise. So many people, Israelites, about 30 lakhs of people, they heard the promise of Lord. What was the promise of the Lord? The promise of the Lord was to give and live peacefully in the land of Canaan, where there is milk and honey. But did these 30 lakhs of people enter the kingdom where God has promised? Did they enter the destination? Did they enter the land of Canaan? No. Only two people and their generation entered the land of Canaan, because in the book of Numbers 29, the chapter 29, chapter 11 says that only the Joshua and the other person, those two people only entered the promised land because they have another spirit. They are very close to, the verse is saying that they were very close to Jesus. So they entered the land. What I am saying is that if you love Jesus with a partial mind, or if you love Jesus without any sincerity, God won't fulfill your promises. If you want your promises to be fulfilled, you must come to Jesus, because he's a God who fulfills his promises. What I'm saying is, in Revelation, the book of Revelation 3:11, he says, I come soon, hold on to what you have. He says, there are seven churches in the Revelation we can see, but to one church, the church of Philadelphia, that is in the third chapter of Revelation, book of Revelation, to the other churches, we could see that they have some defects. They dislike the God. They are not showing much love in the end time, but to the Philadelphia church, we could see that God liked the Philadelphia church because they were sincere, they were loyal to God. So in order to achieve the promise, one thing you have to understand is that you must be loyal to God, because God is knocking at your door. God wants to come and enter your heart. If only your heart is pure, if only you are faithful to God, then God will come and dwell in you. God has promised in the book of John 14:16 that when I go, another comforter will come. We know who is the comforter. That comforter is the Holy Spirit. In the Malayalam Bible, it is said as caretaker. In Malayalam Bible, the word used for the Holy Spirit is Karistan. Karistan means caretaker. You know, in ancient Kerala, in big houses, there were so many caretakers. These caretakers take care of all the things. They pay the electricity bills. They go and do all the outside jobs. They supervise all the works. But you know, Holy Spirit is like that. God has mentioned Holy Spirit in that name, caretaker. That means you don't have to worry about anything. You don't have to go after anything, because he has given a Holy Spirit who is not only a comforter but also a caretaker. I tell you in Jesus' name that in the book of First John chapter 2:27, the verse, it says that, hallelujah, it says that the Spirit which God has poured upon you is enough to advise you, teach you, guide you, and lead you in all the problems you face. Wherever you go, the Spirit which is in you is able to lead you. So understand one thing, if you have that comforter in you, if you have that caretaker in you, if you have that Holy Spirit in you, you don't have to look after others for help, because the Holy Spirit will give whatever you need at the correct time. If you lack anything, if you lack education, He will give you education at the correct time. If you lack money, you know that the Elijah was a prophet. He was praying in the wilderness, but both in the evening and at night, he was fed by God through a raven. You know, the ravens are of having a habit taking the things from people, but here the God fed the Elijah with the ravens. You know, after morning, if Elijah had food from the food brought through ravens, after then he had to pray again for the raven to come. You know one thing, that's God. Our God is a God who takes care of everything. How many of you understand this? How many of you are understanding what I am saying? Because in these days, I am seeing so many people through the TV and media, in YouTube, Facebook, so many media, so many people are watching this message. I understand one thing, so many people's promises are not yet to be fulfilled. Why your promises are not fulfilled? Because you are away from God. In the book of Joshua, 1st chapter 7, 8 and 9, it says that if you meditate the word of God, if you rely the word of God, if you are in the word of God, wherever you go, you will be blessed. Whatever you do, that will be successful. So you want a successful life, you want a blessed life, you want all the promises to be fulfilled. So what I am saying is that you must be in the word, you must obey the word of God, you should not turn left or right from the word of God. You know, the God who lifted Joshua, who helped Joshua to show him as a leader before the Israelites, for that he stopped the sun who ruled the universe. The sun was shining every day. The sun rises at the correct time and sets at the right time. But in order to lift Joshua before the Israelites, God stopped that sun. I say that the God, one who stopped the sun in order to lift Joshua, in order to show that Joshua is a leader, that same God will do a miracle in your life if you believe, because our God is a God who fulfills His promises. Hallelujah. In the book of Isaiah 43:3, it says that, since I love you. In the book of 43:2, it says that, Isaiah, in the book of Isaiah chapter 43, second verse says, since I love you, since you are my beloved, since you are my son, if you walk through water, the water won't get you drowned. If you walk through fire, the fire won't consume you. Understand one thing, but don't jump purposely into the water or into the fire, because God doesn't like those who test God. But if you happen to be in the water, while you travel through the water or while you travel on a boat through the river, nothing, don't get afraid. You know that Jesus' disciples were traveling with Jesus, and at the midnight heavy storm came. And at that meantime, Jesus was sleeping on the boat. And you know what the disciples were doing? They screamed, they cried, Lord, we are going to be drowned in the sea. But Jesus was sleeping very well. How he could sleep? Because he knows that the sea was created by God. And he knows that through his word, the sea was created. So Jesus knows that if I command, the storm will cease. Jesus knows that. That's why he was sleeping very calmly. Understand one thing, if you know Jesus, who he is, you will be silent, your pains will go. I think that you have so many worries in your heart, so many things are in your heart troubling you. I rebuke the Satan which brings all the pain in your heart in order to discourage you from doing the Lord's work. I rebuke that Satan in Jesus' name and let it go away from you. I rebuke that in Jesus' name. What I said is that if you go through water, you won't be drowned. If you happen to be in the fire won't consume you, because Jesus cares you. And in the book of Isaiah 43:4, it says, since I have loved you, since I have called you, since you belong to me, I will give men for you. I will give people for for you. I will give the people's life for you. Understand one thing, our God is a good God who takes care of me. Once a preacher, while he was going for a meeting, happened to be in a traffic jam, and he inquired, pulling out his head out and inquired what was happening in the traffic block. And one person told him one boy was killed in that accident, and one car which was going in front of that preacher's car hit that boy and he was killed. And after that, when the preacher reached the place where the meeting was, and it was a time for the offering prayer, and the God servant who was praying at that time for the offering said, "Is that God servant's lips were directed by Holy Spirit and was saying like that, on the way, Satan had a plan to kill you, but I gave one boy instead of you." So at that time, the preacher thought about that. It was about me. You know that preacher, his name is Brother Suresh Babu. While he was going for a meeting, he was telling that he had to be in an accident. He was to be killed in an accident. That was Satan's plan. But that word came into power. That word came into life. That word came into life in his life, because what that boy was given instead of Brother Suresh Babu. Understand one thing. Our God, whatever promises are there in the Bible, all will be fulfilled. All the promises, not a single promise, even the earth, even everything which is visible in your sight, everything will go. Even the sun will fall down, even the earth will go, but the word which has come from the Lord, it won't go. The word which has come from the Lord will fulfill the thing which God has said. Then only it will return back to Lord. That is the promise of God. How many of you know that in the book of 1 Peter 1:25, grass withers fall, but the word of God remains. What that remains is the word of God. How many of you believe that? And Jesus has promised to his disciples that he will be till the end of the age. And God has given all the authority to Jesus. So Jesus are asking me to do and go everywhere and to make disciples in order to please God. Do whatever Jesus has said in the Bible. Jesus has said so many things. If you do all these things, all these promises will come. You know, Cain and Abel offered sacrifices. God didn't ask them to do a sacrifice. God didn't request them to do a sacrifice, but they gave sacrifice. And you know what happened? God was displeased because he was not sacrificed with a fully mind. He was not committed to God. That's Cain. And you know, Cain was driven out of that place and he was cursed. So it should not come to you. You must obey God. You must read Bible. You must obey what the Bible says. You should not take right or left Bible. Then all the promises will come to you. One day Jesus will come. How many of you are preparing for his second coming? In the book of Colossians, we could see that Jesus is saying that, in the book, Paul is saying that you think about Jesus. Think about his second coming. How many of you are thinking about the Jesus second coming? Most of the people in this world are thinking about the financial debts. Most of them are thinking about their marriage. Most of them are thinking about their future, after what will happen to them after 30 years. So many people are thinking like, but understand one thing. Have you ever thought today, anybody who is hearing this message, have you ever thought that Jesus is coming for the second time? Are you prepared? Get ready to prepare for the second coming of Jesus. Then you will fulfill all the promises. You don't have to go after all the blessings, because all the blessings in Psalms 23, it says that all the blessings will follow. You don't need to follow them, but all the blessings, all the graces will follow you. Now Jesus is going to touch each and one of you. How many of you want all the promises to be fulfilled? If you want the promises to be fulfilled, one thing you have to understand, you must please God. You must please. If you please God, then God will make your promises fulfilled. Let us close our eyes. Heavenly Father, thank you, Father, for giving this time to praise the word of God and those who have heard, let the promises be fulfilled. If they are away from God, if they are away from Bible, let their hearts be cleansed.